most stuff really. Sometimes I'm inspired by watching another film. Like I may watch like a western or a sci-fi or something. Oh, that's really good, but I think I could have done it better. And so I come up with an idea to actually make, you know, to kind of use something which I thought was quite a good idea and put my own spin on it. Sometimes it's through my own life.
Yeah.
You know, you have aspects of your own life. The best writers take elements of their own life or stuff that's happened to them in their life or stuff that's happened to their family or friends, and you basically use that life experience and then fictionalise it to make it exciting. So sometimes, yeah, sometimes it's aspects of things that have happened to me, and sometimes you kind of, rather than go out and get a gun and kill people, you actually...
It happens to you.
Yeah, you actually find a way to kind of get rid of all that kind of darkness that may be inside you, or anger, and you release it through writing. Well, the key thing to remember with writing is there's no right or wrong way to write something. There's a correct way to format something. That's the skill you would need before wanting to write anything. You would need to learn how to format a script. What that means is the way a script is actually laid out on the page. The way the industry works is, if you was to send, say you had a great idea and you just write it out handwritten and you sent it to a producer or a director or a production company, a TV company, if they looked at it and it's not formatted correctly, it doesn't matter if it's the greatest idea in the world, they will throw it in the bin. They won't even look past page one. So the main skill to learn is how to format a script and then how to structure it. The actual content of a story, you know, whatever your story may be, there's no right or wrong answer for that, because that's what you yourself want to put across, what you yourself want to say to the audience. And never let anyone tell you that you have to say certain things or have certain characters. It's about what you want and what you want to watch. If you write something and you like it, then there's going to be an audience out there.
Turn up the lights in here, baby. Extra bright, I want y'all to see this. Turn up the lights in here, baby. You know what I need, want you to see everything. Want you to see all the lights.
So the film itself is actually already finished, and it maybe will be coming out in like 3 to 4 months.
Yeah.
And the film company wants to know what kind of people it's going to appeal to the most. So they want to kind of find out the kind of people that are going to come to see the film. And also they do want to know what people think about it.
Yeah.
Because that helps them market it as well. Well, I initially trained as an actor, and I guess part of me thinks I should have stuck with the acting.
Yeah.
But actually, I gave up acting, not to do this job, actually, to go into singing. And that's what I mainly do now. And what I love about my current job in the movie industry is that it's very flexible.
Yeah.
So it's not a 9-to-5, you know, Monday to Friday job. I basically get work every time a new project comes in. Something wrong, I hold my head. MJ gone, I'm dead. I slapped my girl, she called the feds. I did that time and spent that bread. I'm headed home, I'm almost there. I'm on my way, headed up the stairs. To my surprise, replacing me, I had to take him to that ghetto university. Absolutely, because the executive team, sort of like the main people in the company where I work, they're market research experts, and they've all studied, you know, market research at university, or they've had jobs in market research before. And that market research is basically all the data that we collect. So all those questionnaires of all those people, that is basically data for us. And they are the, sort of, the experts that analyze that data and then report back to the film company the findings of the data. So to get into their role, then it's probably, you probably need to study market research.
Yeah.
And there's lots of, I think, lots of maths involved. Flashlights, spotlights, strobe lights, street lights, all of the lights, all of the lights. Fast life, drug life, thug life, rock life. do is technically field. So field means like out there in the field, if you like. Going to places like Kingston, where we'll do a test screening, and we'll actually walk around Kingston with a load of cinema tickets, and we'll give out cinema tickets to certain age ranges of people and certain types of people to come and see the film. So you don't need qualifications as such to do what I do. The main thing you need is passion. And luckily, I absolutely love movies. I'm an unashamed movie geek. I love everything from all black and white movies right up to like modern day action films. So I never find the job boring because I never know what the next film is going to be. We have had that a few times actually. I've had people come up to me in the street and they go, oh, this sounds like a really interesting job. Are there any jobs going? And I say, well, I'll write down my boss's number and I say, you know, give her a call, because we always need people. So yeah, there's lots of people who find it interesting. And as I was saying to the other group, you know, what I love about my job is that I know so many friends of mine who are like budding actors or artists or singers who have like really boring jobs. Now, they're working in a pub or a bar or a restaurant, and I'm just really lucky that I've got a job that in between my performing, I've got a job that actually pays the bills but also is something I'm really passionate about. They're a really friendly company. In fact, media itself is very kind of, I think if you're in media, something, it's not like being an accountant, it's fun as well. So they tend to be sort of quite fun people. And the actual clients that we work with are like major film studios. So they're like important people. They literally like fly over from America and they'll be in the screening. Sometimes you can have a famous director, or sometimes on rare occasions you can have actually the star of the show. And what's quite funny about that is we have to sneak them in. Because if people know that the star of the show is there,
everyone will just fuck.
The data, everyone's going, oh, it's brilliant, because they see that he's there.
So does it sort of make everyone go a bit giddy, like,
ooh? Well, actually, what will happen is that the way that we technically do it, little industry secret here, is that we'll wait for the film to start. So the lights have gone down, the film has started, and maybe a couple of minutes into the movie, we sneak them in. They usually wear like a little cap and stuff. They'll have a little chair right by the entrance, and they'll kind of sit across the film, and then before the film even finishes, they're out the door. So hopefully no one
will even know.
Realized, you're sitting next to someone.
Restraining order. Can't see my daughter. Her mother, brother, grandmother hate me in that order.
Public visitation. We met at Borders. Told us to take me back. So at the beginning, I did genuinely want to be an actor. That was my main focus. And this job in the media, in the film industry, I thought I was only going to do for a few months, and then I'd be going off and starring in films and everything like that. But now, actually, that I've been in the kind of film side of it, it's made me want to think, well, you know, maybe, because I've seen so many films and I've seen the process that they go through, I'm thinking, well, maybe I could write a script that could do well, or maybe I could produce a film. So one day, that would be one of my dreams, is to actually at least write and direct a film. I made mistakes, I bumped my head, and court sucked me dry. I spent that bread, she need a daddy, baby please. Actually, because you're not going straight into a 9-to-5 job necessarily, but you're going into the industry, so there's a lot of apprenticeships. In a way, one of the best things to do is probably write to the companies. You could probably spend a day walking around Soho. I mean, Soho is the main media place in London. Around sort of Wardour Street, places like that, we've got loads of like screening rooms and places like that. So you could always just print off a load of CVs and then just go around, hand them out. Find the details online. If you just Google film marketing, film research, and the companies will come up. And it's a great job, and even if it's something you just want to try, maybe for a summer. It was. I just replied to the advert, and they brought me in for it in the interview. And I just said, I love films, and this would be a great job to do in between acting. I don't think it's exactly easy to suddenly become a director.
Yeah.
It's not easy to become a cameraman or anything like that, because they're very specific
skills.
Jobs. And also they're jobs that lots of people want to do. Loads of people want to become directors.
Yeah.
You know, loads of people want to become cameramen. But if you say to people, you know, film marketing and film research,